हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल सी वन पॉइंट लेफ्ट इन फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज़ टेंस कॉम्प्लीमेंट सब्ट्रैक्शन. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द सब्ट्रैक्शन, बीसीडी सब्ट्रैक्शन यूजिंग टेंस कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो वंस कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड टूज कॉम्प्लीमेंट सब्ट्रैक्शन वी आर डूइंग विद द बाइनरी सब्ट्रैक्शन, एंड नाइन्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड टेंस कॉम्प्लीमेंट सब्ट्रैक्शन वी आर डूइंग विद द बीसीडी नंबर्स, राइट. So some rules of nines complement and ones complements are same. If carry is generated, answer is positive, add that carry into answer. If carry is not generated, then answer is negative and take the nines complement of final answer. So these two rules for nines complement and ones complement are same. So some rules from two's complement are same with tens complement. So we'll see what are that rules. So first, before going to do the tens complement subtraction, we'll see the rules of tens complement subtraction. That is, if two numbers are given, a minus b, right? So first rule is take tens complement of b. That is number to be subtracted, tens complement of b. That means this subtrahed, we can call it as. Then what is a tens complement? First find out a nines complement of number, then add 1 to it, right? So nines complement plus 1 is nothing but your tens complement, is nothing but your tens complement, right? So how to calculate nines complement? In previous lecture we have seen that how to calculate nines complement. So adding 1 into nines complement will give you tens complement. So what is the first rule? Take tens complement of b, then add a plus tens complement of b. Third rule, if carry is generated, if carry is generated, answer is positive, answer is positive, discard or ignore that carry, discard or ignore that carry. So in nines complement and in tens complement we are adding that carry, here we are discard or ignore carry, right. Then fourth rule, if carry is not generated, if carry is not generated, answer is negative. Take tens complement of final answer. Take tens complement of final answer. So these are the rules. Now, here we have to check one condition. After addition of a and tens complement of b, check whether the result is greater than 9 or less than 9, because if the result is greater than 9, then it is invalid BCD. We have to add 6 to it to make it valid BCD. If answer is less than 9 but carry is 0, then also invalid BCD, you have to add 6 to it. And if answer is less than 9 and carry is equals to 0, then it is valid BCD. If answer is less than 9, carry is generated, then it is invalid BCD. So what are the condition? Here we have to check at second step. If answer is greater than 9, it is invalid BCD. You have to add 6 to make it valid BCD, first condition. Second condition, if answer is less than 9 and carry is 1, then it is invalid BCD. Add 6 to make it valid BCD. Third condition, answer is less than 9, carry equal to 0, then only it is valid BCD, no correction is required here. So this condition, these three condition you have to check at step number 2. When you perform A plus tense complement of B, you have to check these three conditions. If valid BCD is there, no correction is required. If invalid BCD is there, these two cases are there, you have to add 6 there to make that answer valid BCD. And then apply this third and fourth rule. If carry is generated, answer is positive, discard that carry. If carry is not generated, answer is negative, take tens complement of final answer. Here carry is not generated, last condition. So by applying this rule, now we will check tens complement BCD subtraction. In previous lecture we have seen nines complement subtraction, so in that case we are taking nines complement here. Here if carry is generated, we are adding that carry into our final answer and we are considering our answer is positive. If carry is not generated, answer is negative. We were taking nines complement of final answer. So here some rule has changed. Here if carry is generated, we will ignore this carry in tens complement and consider our answer is positive. If carry is not generated, we will consider answer is negative and we will take a tens complement of final answer, right? So we will solve some example how to apply the rules and how to find out the correct answer, right? So first we will see 8 decimal minus 3 decimal. So in decimal, the result of this subtraction should be 5. So we need this answer with our tens complement subtraction. So first we'll take the tens complement of this, because this is A, this is B. So we'll find out tens complement of this. So before finding tens complement, we must know the nines complement of this number. So we'll first find out nines complement of B, that means 6. We'll add 1 to 8. So this will give me tens complement of 3. So 7 is a tens complement of 3. What I have done? 9 minus 3, I have taken nines complement of 3. Then I have added 1 to it. That will give me tens complement of B. So this is a tens complement. Now this tens complement I will add into A. And what is A? A is 8. So A is 8. And B is tens complement 7. So I need to add these two, but I will represent these numbers into BCD because it is a BCD subtraction, right? So I will take BCD of 8, which is this 4 bit BCD, and for 7 it is 0111, right? So 0 plus 1 1, 0 plus 1 1, 0 plus 1 1, 1 plus 0 1. Now you can see that here the result is greater than 9, that means it is invalid BCD. Invalid BCD, you have to add 6 to make it valid BCD. So we'll add 6, 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1, 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1. Now if carry is generated, apply rule number 3. If carry is generated, answer is positive. Carry is generated, answer is positive, and ignore carry or discard carry. So we'll write our answer without this carry because we are ignoring this carry. So our answer is 0101, which is in decimal or binary, which is equivalent to 5 decimal. So we got the correct answer using tens complement BCD subtraction. Now we'll see next example. 4 minus 9, and result should be minus 5. So we'll prove this minus 5 with BCD. Tens complement BCD subtraction. So first we'll find out the tens complement of 9. So tens complement of 9 is 9 minus 9 0 plus 1 is 1. So tens complement of 9 is 1. Now we'll add this tens complement into this, means 4. So we'll do 4 plus 1. But we'll put this number into BCD, that means 4 bit binary 0100 plus 0001. We'll perform the binary addition 0 plus 1 1, 0 plus 0 0, 1 plus 0 1, 0 plus 0 0. Now here carry is not generated, so answer is negative. Carry is not generated, answer is negative. And take tens complement of final answer. Take tens complement of final answer. Right. So tens complement means this is a decimal 5. 9 minus 5 is 4. And 4 plus 1 is 5. But it is minus 5 because carry is not generated. So it is equivalent to minus 5. Right. So this is our final answer, means minus 5. So we have got correct answer with the help of tens complement BCD subtraction, right? Now writing comment is necessary because here we are applying a rule. Which rule we have applied, you have to write over here. If carry is generated, not generated, what we have done, you have to write here. Now we'll see the next example. -15. This is A, this is B. I need to find a tens complement of 15. So I will first find out 9's complement of 15. So finding 9's complement means subtracting each digit from 9. That's why I have taken 99, because I have to find out the 9's complement of each digit. So 9's complement will give me 84 plus 1, 85. So this is my 10's complement of 15. So I will add this 85 with this. So 37 plus 85, right? Now I will represent this 37 and 85 in BCD form. BCD form means each digit, represent each digit into 4 bit binary. So this 3 0 0 1 1, 7 is 0 triple 1, 8 is 1 triple 0, and 5 is 0 1 0 1. Now I will perform a binary addition. 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 0 plus 1 1, 1 plus 0 0, 1 plus 0 1, 1 plus 0 1, 0 plus 0 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. Right. Now here you can see invalid BCD is, we got invalid BCD. Here we check first once again, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 0 plus 0 0, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 0 plus 1 1, 1 plus 0 1, sorry, here mistakenly I have written 0, 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1. So now you can see this is greater than 9, this is also greater than 9, means these both numbers are invalid BCD. We have to add 6 in these two numbers. So we'll add 0 1 1 0 0 0 sorry 0 1 1 0 at both the sides, and we'll perform binary addition once again. 0 plus 0 0 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 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 1 right, and carry is generated, so answer is positive. You have to discard this carry, ignore this carry, right? Now here 22 answer, which is equivalent to 22 decimal. If you perform decimal subtraction, here also you will get 37 minus 52, 22. So this answer is correct. Now we'll take another example. So in decimal 73 minus 46 result should be minus 17. Sorry, minus 27. Minus 27, we are expecting a result minus 27. So we'll first find out the tens complement of this. 99 minus 73, 26 plus 1 27. So we'll make addition of these two with the BCD numbers. So 46 means 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0, and 27 means 0 0 1 0 0 triple 1 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 0 1 0 plus 0 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 0 1. So this is invalid BCD. We'll add 6 over here. 1 plus 0 1 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1 1 1 1 0. Now here answer is 73. Carry is not generated, so answer is negative. Carry is not generated, answer negative. Take tens complement of final answer. So 99 minus 73 is 26 plus 1 is 27, and carry is not generated, that's why we are considering this answer is negative. So this is the final answer. So this is the tens complement. We are finding the correct answers which we have got in decimal subtraction. Now one last point, that means grade 2 binary and binary to gray conversion. Grade 2 binary and binary to gray conversion. So what is this concept? We have seen the number systems in our first lecture. That is, there are four basic number system: decimal, binary, hexadecimal and octal. There is another some coding codes are there, which is also called as a gray code or excess 3 codes. So how to find out that codes we will see here, right? So how to convert gray code into binary, we'll see. Now to convert gray code into binary, we are using some logic, that is, consider A and B combinations which we have seen binary addition, that is common four possible combination, that means 00, 01, 10 and 11, right? If both the bits are even, means equal, so in this case the output is 0, right? Means for first and fourth condition, both the bits are equal, or you can say that even, right? Means in this condition A and B both are equal, 00, and in this condition A and B both are equal, that is 1. So for such combinations of input, the output is 0, right? And in this case, in these two case, here the odd combinations of bits is there, that means here 0. If A is 0, B is 1. If A is 1, B is 0. That means this is called as an odd combination. So output is 1. So you can see that, you can say that for odd combinations of input, the output is high, and for even combinations of input, output is low. So we have to apply this logic while converting our gray code into binary or binary to gray code. Now we'll see. Keep this concept in your mind. For even combinations of input, the output is low. For odd combinations of input, output is high. Right? You have to keep this concept in your mind, because we are going to apply this concept while converting gray to binary or binary to gray. Now, how to find out a gray code from binary code from binary code from gray code, we'll see. Example, suppose the number is given 10010. So this is the binary number given, and you have to find gray code for it. Find gray code. Okay. So how we will do this conversion? Will copy this bit as it is, means copy first bit as it is, right? And check the combination of this adjacent bit, right? So 10 will give you 10 will give you 1. Now check the combination of this adjacent bit. 00 will give you 0. Now 01 will give you 1. 10 will give you 1. So this is the gray code. So this is the method of finding gray code from given binary. Now you can see that here is 5 bit binary is given, 1 2 3 4 5. So here also we got 5 bit in gray. So such code is called as a gray code, right? How we have found it, we are just taken the combination of adjacent bit, right? And we have applied rule of this condition, right? Now we'll see another example. Second example, first copy this number as it is and check the combination of adjacent bit. 11 will give you 0, 10 will give you 1, 01 will give you 1, 11 will give you 0, 10 will give you 1. So this is the gray code. Again we'll see another example. 10011. This binary is given to you. You have to copy first bit and check the combination of adjacent bit. 10010 means you have to write 1 year. 00 means 0. 01 will give you 1. And 11 will give you 0. means even combination will give you 0, odd combination will give you 1. So this is the gray code. We will see next example. 4 times 1, we have to convert this number into gray. So first we'll copy first bit and we'll check the pair of this adjacent bit. 1 will give you 0. 1 will give you 0. 1 will give you 0. Even bit combination will give you 0 output. Then next example, 10110.101. Copy this number 1. Check the combination of these two. 10 will give you 1. 01 will give you 1. 11 will give you 0. 01 will give you 1. Now copy this 1 as it is. Here keep fractional point as it is. Copy this 1. 10 will give you 1. 01 will give you 1. So this is the conversion. Now suppose this decimal number is given and you have to find out the gray code. Find gray of 23. So you have to convert this number into binary first. So binary of 23 is 10111, and then convert it into gray. So copy this one as it is. 10, combination of 10 will give you 1. 01 will give you 1. 11 will give you 0. 11 will give you 0. So this is the gray code of 23. Right. Next is given 46 in decimal. You have to find out the gray code for this. So first you have to convert this number into binary. The binary of 46 is 10110. Copy this number 1. Check the combination of these two. Will give you 1. 01 will give you 1. 11 will give you 0. 11 will give you 0. 10 will give you 1. So this is the gray of 46. Now we'll see how to convert gray to binary. Here we have seen binary to gray conversion. Now we'll see gray to binary. Again you have to apply the logic. 00 will give you 0, 01 will give you 1, 10 will give you 1, and 11 will give you 0. Again we are applying same logic here. Now gray to binary means this gray number is given and you have to convert this gray number into binary. So copy first bit as it is and check the combination of these two. 11 will give you 0. 00 will give you 0. 01 will give you 1. 10 will give you 1. So you have to check now the combination of these bits which is diagonal to each other. Right. In binary to gray, we are checking the combination of this adjacent bit. Now here we have to check the combination of these two, which is in the diagonal direction. We'll see another example. 101101. This gray is given. We have to convert this number into binary. So what we'll do first, we'll copy first bit as it is 1. And we'll check the combination of this 10. This 10 means give you 1. Now again I have to check this both combination of this 2, which will give me 0. Now I will check the combination of this 2. This will give me 1. Now I will check combination of this 2. This will give me 1. And this will give me 11 will give me 0. So likewise I have to find out. Now third, we'll see one another example. First copy as it is 1. Now check the combination of these two. 1 1 will give you 0. 0 1 will give you 1. 1 0 will give you 1. 1 1 will give you 0. 0 1 will give you 1. So this is the grade 2 binary conversion. Now we'll see how to find the excess 3 code. Excess 3 code. How we derive excess 3 code? We'll simply add 3 to it. Means suppose five is given. We have to find out the excess 3 of this code, excess 3. So we'll add 3 to it. 5 plus 3 is equals to 8. That means 4 bit binary of 8 is 1000. This is the excess 3 of 5. Great. Now the number is given 51. We have to find out excess 3 code. So what we'll do? 51 plus 33 is 84, and I will represent this number into excess 3 like 1000 0100. So this is excess 3 of 51. Now 46, we have to find out excess 3 of 46. So 46 plus 33, answer is 79. We'll represent it into excess 3. So this is excess 3. This means we have represented into 4 bit binary. Then we'll see 246. We have to convert this number into excess 3. So 246 plus, we have to add 3 into each digit. That means 9, 7, 5. So 579 I will represent into 4 bit binary. So this is excess 3 of 246. Now 327 given. We have to find out excess 3 of 327. So I will add 3 to each digit. I will represent this 66 like 3. So this is the method of finding 3 code. Previous we have seen how to find out the gray to binary and binary to gray code. So here we have completed our chapter number 1. Tomorrow there will be class test 1, which is based on chapter 1 question. Then I will provide you assignment for this chapter. We'll send assignment question in your WhatsApp group. Thank you.